Hi guys, Isidora here. Thanks for coming back to my channel. It's a triathlon channel and today's topic will be triathlon suits. When I started triathlon 15 years ago, I had no means to buy a triathlon suit. So I was wearing some retro swimsuits, then I changed, I went cycling, I had some cycling gear on, and then again I changed and I put my running gear on. Was it really handy? Of course not, because I was losing a lot of time to get changed twice during the race, but that was my only chance, I didn't have any means. So when I had really some additional money, I invested in a dry suit, which proved to be one of the greatest investments in my triathlon career. So I can recommend you to do the same. If you can, then buy a triathlon suit for your upcoming season. There are two different types of triathlon suits. There is one with one piece and there is a different one with two pieces. Now, it's really your preference what you prefer. So for example, the elite athletes who are doing the sprint distances and also the Olympic distance, they usually use a one-piece suit without pockets because they just don't need any pockets. It's done in an hour or so. So yeah, 2 hours for the Olympic distance. So they don't need too much gels in the pockets and such stuff. Also, if it's a wetsuit league race, it doesn't really matter if you have a one-piece on or a two-piece on. You can just manage it. Also doesn't matter how many pockets do you have at your back. But if it's not a wetsuit allowed race, so it's for example a very warm race in Kona, you can put a swim skin on, which you like use like a wetsuit. So you are using the normal triathlon suit and you put this swim skin on, which is really reducing your drag. It's just a great material in the water. So you're just swimming in a t-shirt and without a top, or for the women, yeah, of course a bra, but after you exit the swim, then you put on an additional layers and your issue is already solved in a way. Definitely make sure that you are testing your suit before the race. It can cause really, really many surprises. Discomfort will not be a good thing on your race day. Definitely if you are doing like a half distance or a full distance, you have to make sure that you tested your suit before the race. Personally, I like the one-piece suit up until the half distance, and usually for the full distance I'm using a two-piece suit because of the toilet breaks, for example. It can be really handy to use the two-piece suit for the longer distance. I would like to introduce you two of my favorite companies who are producing triathlon gear. As an idea, of course, there are hundreds of other companies with hundreds of great products, so it's only my personal preference. So for the one-piece suit, I usually use Zoot. You can see one of their products. I will also just put a picture about me racing to this video. They also produce two-piece suits. Those are not my favorites. I prefer the one-piece from them. Another company from the US is SOAS. This is one of their shorts. For the two pieces, this is my favorite brand without question mark. They also produce one-piece suits. They are also great, but for two pieces, definitely this is my preference. I had quite some issues in the past because of the top was rolling up. These are their tops. But I will also put some pictures on wearing the suit. This is not rolling up, causing no discomfort, so they are really, really great. And also they started as a women specific brand, so they also know everything about the women geometry. So kudos for SOAS. This was my short introduction video about the triathlon suits. If you already have one, please let me know in the comment box what is your favorite company, what is your favorite type of tri suit. I would be really interested, and also some other people can use this as a reference. If you like the video, please don't forget to give a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. Be active and be safe there. Bye!